For me, you have to be thrifty nowadays. You work too hard for your money.
Thank you. All right. Let's go. Finally, the match starts. Switching. In the bottom left corner, it is from Team UnRivaled, their player Parker. In the top right corner, it is from ValidG, the Protoss player Magic. Why is the caster pinging that, by the way? Anyways, this tournament is called VTL Pro, which means Validity Team League. That means the teams are facing each other, team versus team. And in this format, it is actually basically 4 versus 4, meaning one player faces the other player. Meanwhile, there's 4 players on each team, and they have to play only one. Connected. So they have to play only one time, and they will play up to 4 games. I mean 4 wins. So the first guy, first team who wins to 4 games, I'm sorry, wins this week's tournament. So as we can see, Metric is a cannon rushing right now. As you can see here, Forge at right here. Meanwhile, Parker is pulling the drones in order to avoid getting the cannon rushed, which is a bit too late right now. This hatch is gonna die down anyways from this cannon. So what Park is going to do now is get a second gas, and maybe a Roach Baron right now, which is could be hope. Yeah, there it is. It doesn't really look looking good for Parker, because there's no way Parker can save with only 3 links. So there might be a hope for Parker to get spines and roach spam, but I'm not sure. So far there's 2 gates and some cannons. Meanwhile the second hatch is about to get destroyed. Meanwhile there's so many links and queens right here waiting for the opportunity to take. Now the link are trying to do damage against cannons, which is really nice to do damage. Now the stock is out, might be doing damage. So the second hatch is down, now up left is the hatch at the main base. Meanwhile, Metric has completely walled off with only one gas, which means there could be no stargates. Only stalkers right now with 2 warp gates, and more shield batteries are coming up. Meanwhile, Parker is now sieging up with 2 spines, queens, and yeah, creep tumor. Oh, by the way, I'm sorry for the German language. Four stalkers are out, meanwhile 2 batteries are finished, and 2 more, 1 pylon and batteries coming up. Three ravagers are out, which might be potentially damaging cannons, but there's 5 stalkers, which are a bit too strong against 3 Ravagers. The spine is going down, links are being pulled, trying to do some damage, but getting denied. Meanwhile, stalkers are doing damage, trying to kite. One ravager is down. Second ravager is down. The stalker is still alive, strong, getting healed by the shield batteries. The drones are now being pulled. Magic is trying to take down the pull, but it's targeting fire the ravager. Cannot really do damage now. Another roach is down. And that GG has been caught. Magic takes this first game of today, which is. Which is 1-0 for ValidG gaming, I'm sorry. GG. What a degen, Ken and Russia. The second game is about to start. We are currently waiting for the second game to start soon. Do I need to explain more about VTL Pro? Usually in the VTL Pro there's a certain MMR set. For the first spot, the players up to... there's 4 slots for each team. The first slot is up to 4600 MMR. Second slot is 5000. Third slot is 5500, and fourth is also as well 5500. So each player will play face each other up to a certain MMR to be a bit fair, but there's of course some players that thanks for the follow, David. David, oh, seriously? It's a bit small, this one, huh? Let me change the stream alert a bit. There we go. Fireclaw is about to face Nevermind. Fireclaw is 4500-ish. And he's a Portal player. Okay, second game is about to start soon. Alright, switching to this game. On this second game is Schwarzbrand, which means Blackburn, of course. At the bottom left corner, it is from team UnRivaled, Protoss player named Fireclaw. At the bottom right corner, it is from the team Validity Gaming, or what shortened Validity. It is Red Circ called Nevermind. Alright. Let's see what they're planning now. The prop scouting. And as we can see, Nevermind is going gas first, with a pool behind it. Meanwhile, Fireclaw is just chilling at the natural, and is about to scout the pool first, soon. And it is pool first. Though he didn't really check... Oh, there's a gas. Okay, he checked at the gas. Alright. Now he's about to check if there is gold mineral. Now, as Julia is mentioning, the chrono boost is late, which I have literally no clue. So, as we can see, there's a barely war with a warp gate and cybercore with a nexus after that. Now, I'm curious if Fireclaw is gonna wall off just in time. Meanwhile, Nevermind is just skirting around the wall, how it's built, and so on. The second gas from Fireclaw is coming up. Meanwhile, Nevermind is getting a second hatch in the natural. And chasing down the probe. Trying to deny the scout, which is really important because he might be up something like this. Now, there's a good chance that Fireclaw is gonna scout the Roach Baron. But, Nevermind denies it with the Queen. In the meanwhile, Fireclaw is not really well enough right here. I wonder if it's enough to bully the Adept with just two links. Probably not. Now Nevermind is getting link speed as well, meanwhile with the 5 roaches behind it, right here. And Fireclaw is getting a star gate. I'm sorry for the late reaction. I barely look at the production, but I need to learn how to guess with the production tab. So, Fireclaw is getting a fight ray. And Nevermind is just pushing. Oh, never mind, got in. No, never mind, it's about to destroy this pylon right now. Which is very important. Now the white ray is out. Is Fireclaw gonna save his game? Or is Nevermind gonna destroy and tank this game? Who knows? So Nevermind is doing decent damage, but as well as Fireclaw. As we can see, I don't know how many workers died. Oh, 16, 17 workers, 19, 20, and GG has called. Nevermind takes the second game on the map Blackburn. I actually thought Fireclaw is gonna take this game with White Ray, but no. Okay. That was tough actually, but. Alright, it is 2-0 for ValidG. Alright. Which is the next map? Are we gonna vote or not? Also, I need to update the score in the game, so I'm sorry about that as well. But I think I have to add the overlay of this score onto the screen, so I don't forget next time. But today I'm gonna try to remember myself and update the score. I really don't like a 2-minute delay, but I have to, so there should be fair play around it. We are currently waiting for the third player to wake up. Apparently he went AWOL, so it's gonna be tough right now.
Thank you.
Alright guys, we are about to start the game. Alright, I have to start and switch the game. In the third game. On the map Romantis side, in the bottom right corner, it is from ValidG, Team ValidG, Reichschiller. Also called Kawaii Killer, for some reason. In the top left corner, it is from Team UnRivaled, I guess, as a mercenary, actually Team Alpha, IX, Alpha X, last surprise. Which is kinda surprising for me, that they got a Merc mercenary. The bottoms. Anyways, it's 2-0 for us. For ValidG, I mean, I'm trying not to be biased right now. So far, so pretty much macro opening right here. Right, Reichzilla hasn't played the single game since March 2021, I'm sorry. And by the way, he's getting two double gas right here. Which could mean it's gonna be proxy void, right? As we can see. I love Oof, thank you for the follow. Now, the last surprise is about the scout double gas right here. First gas is scout and second gas is also scout, and now he's gonna react to it. One bunker down here, Reaper is about the scout, he needs to save the pylon right here. The Reaper is about to come, might be building bunker soon as well. Is he seeing it? Yep, he is. Proxy White Ray. The Reaper is about to come. And he's making bunker right here. To destroy the pylon. Oh my god, my voice is gone. Meanwhile, last surprise is building eBay in the natural to deny the Nexus. Oh, he got denied. Which is a bit unfortunate. The eBay has been built completely. Meanwhile, the Star Guide is about to be destroyed right here. Second Nexus is down. With a pylon. Meanwhile, last surprise, I tried to deny with this eBay, which is a bit too late right now. Last surprise is about to do some damage against probes. Meanwhile, Adep is about trying to chase down. The third commence. Okay, second commence center was cancer, so there's under the near second command center, meanwhile Stargate is about to be destroyed and Cyclone is coming out soon. Now Cover Killer, or also called Reichstiller, is getting Twilight Conceal. I think it's called Twilight Conceal, isn't it? Twilight something. Twilight. Last surprise is supply blocked for a bit. There is no never mind. The command center is finished. It's no more supply blocked. And the Cyclone is here waiting for the aggression. Blink Stalker. We are about to see the aggression from Last Surprise pretty much soon. As we can see, we have 3-1-1 with a tank. And maybe more tanks will come soon as well. He needs to destroy this bunker in order to get money back. Right, Zilla is proxying another pylon at the fourth base of Lost Surprise. And scouts. And dies. Instantly. So, I assume it's gonna be just Blink Stalker aggression right here. That means he has to move the Stalker across the map. With a few Stalkers warping in here. So he can just harass. And there's also an opinion from Julia. I have literally no clue how to play Brothers, so. Yeah. Is he forgetting this, this pylon right here? I don't know what he is doing right now. Meanwhile. Right, Julia is just getting a ninja base right here. At 2 o'clock of the map. And, no surprise, it's just getting a 3cc. And Mark Rain up. Meanwhile, Redzilla is just checking out what's going on here. Okay, there's 3-1-1 with 3cc. It's kind of funny to me. Twilight console, okay, thank you, never mind. 2 minutes later. So, we are witnessing Redzilla making Robo Bay with a forge behind it. Maybe Redzilla is just placing it down in order to know, okay, if there is a third base or not. I assume that. Last Surprise is scanning right here. And he finished Steam and Combat Shear as well. But Redzilla doesn't see the move out, which is kind of problematic. Oh, no, he knows, okay. So, Last Surprise is moving to the second base, I can say. Usually it's third base. So I think Last Surprise is just sieging up the tanks right here. So he can just, Is he gonna just... Is the within in range? Yeah. Right, only one tank. Colossoy got matrixed and dies by aim, moving command. It doesn't look good for Redzilla, and the migration of probes has started. And Last Surprise is just chasing down. And this guy has a ninja base right here. Oh boy. Redzilla is trying to chase down the Last Surprise army. Meanwhile, loses 22 probes. Is he multiplying now? He's not trying to damage this Nexus. Now, Last Surprise is getting the whole army to potentially aim off into Reichzeller. Second Colossi is coming up, I mean, it's actually, oh yeah, okay, second one, alright. There's a lot of tanks, potentially zoning out Redzilla soon. And the third base of Last Surprise has been established already. That should be fast CC soon. Finish soon. Wait, they have 5 Rexes right now? One disruptor is coming up soon and has just started the Charles upgrade. This is not looking well for Regzilla because he left his third base undefended. Is he gonna recall? Apparently not. There's so many tanks, no way Regzilla is gonna save this game. There might be a GG as well. Soon. Losing Colossal as well as his game. GG has been caught, last surprise from team playing for Team UnRivaled. Takes the game. It's 2-1. Cactus, thanks for the sub. I appreciate it. I didn't expect it. Okay, the score is right now 2-1. Two games left. No, actually not one. Only one last game is left. If we are reaching to 2-2, then it's gonna be an ace match. Meaning one player can be picked from their own representative team to play each face each other in a ace match to break the tie. I love how Julia is just talking in the observer chat, and you meanwhile you get to see what is talked about. Thanks for the follow, never mind. We are about to start the fourth game soon. Alright, switching now. On this map, Schattenlicht means light shade in English. As we can see, the bottom right corner, it is blue terrain playing for standing in for Team UnRivaled. It is blue terrain. I love oof. Or as you can say, I love oof. The bottom top left corner, it is orange borders playing for ValidG. It is Junior, also called Water Crystal. Might also call her Junior in this game. Just for the better casting experience, I'm gonna update this score now. It's 2-1 for ValidG. Gate first. Meanwhile, Terran is going for Rex, Gers. Pretty much marker opening. Yeah. Father Krista is usually playing on EU server, meanwhile Isle of Oof is apparently playing on NA, which why is his GM. Julia is scouting around, checking out if there's anything fishy. Fun fact, by the way, Father Krista always checks the amount, gas amount. So she can calculate how much the opposite is needing the gas. So as we can see, Alofuf is going for Reaper Fast Expand. Meanwhile, Father Christo, Julia, I mean, is going for Nexus first and before Cybercore and Gas. I hope I got it right because I didn't really pay attention. I'm sorry about that again. Olaf Oof. Let's just call him Oof, okay? Oof. it's getting a factory with Marine after Reaper. Reaper is coming up to scout. Meanwhile, sending SV to home. Mother Crystal is getting Twilight Concio. Which means usually aggression. I wonder if I love Oof already saw this actual concern. Apparently he didn't see it. So he might think he's safe now, but this is missing information right here. Or maybe this is enough to see this double gas right here and says, okay, this is gonna be very aggressive. But still, he didn't see this Twilight Concern. Apparently it's gonna be wieder mein Job build from the Terran player. Mother Krista is getting Blink Stalker aggression. I wonder if it's gonna go well. Two Warp Gates. Easy gonna Rex Guard. There's Sentry already being ready to deny this guard. I don't know if the damage is enough. No. It's not gonna be enough. He scouts, rescouted the Twilight Council, so Oof should be prepared to defend against Blinkstalker aggression. I mean, it could be charge all in, because there's no second, third and fourth gas. Water Crystal is getting 30 Nexus. Meanwhile, Oof is getting 3-1-1 right now. Is he getting Tech Lab on Factory right now? I'm not sure. Okay, triple with a Mind Shop, which is actually very old build. Usually, nowadays, you get only two with a Mine and then get fast Tech Lab in order to protect yourself from Blinkstalker. But I'm curious how it's gonna do it. I wonder if Julia scouted. I'm not sure.
Forschung abgeschlossen.
Should be seen right now here. Yep. She sees it. Oh. Oh no. No, no, no. Ooh, 6 bro has been killed, and only one Wiedermann is alive. Where is the third Wiedermann? I actually missed out. This is... I think it got sniped. Nice catch, Walter Crystal. I keep mixing up the names. Yikes. Now, Oof is getting Raven. With that steam and combat shield at the same time. And plus one attack. Water Crystal is now getting charged a lot and plus one attack. Is this a plus one attack or armor? Wait, this is armor. It's armor. Wait, can I just check here? No, I cannot. I cannot really check what upgrades I got. Okay, this is just armor. No attack. Just armor. Water Crystal is getting Templar Archive, whatever. And is also getting plus one attack. Meanwhile, Water Crystal is microing her Stalkers. To deny the move out. Stalkers are really good at kiting and is... Oh! Okay. She's catching the tank. Nice catch. But Wolf is going to move out anyways. Trying to destroy this third Nexus. So, Water Crystal knows and is getting ship batteries. Second pylon, one High Templar with a couple of Zealots. So it's gonna be really, really close. Steam is already ready and combat shield is also down. So it's gonna be a huge damage. I'm not sure who's winning this game. Okay, this game. This battle. Ship battery overcharge has been activated and the Archon is really dangerous to face. Okay, Water Crystal cannot really snipe the Water Medivac. Meanwhile, Oof's third city is finished and is about to finish the OC upgrade for Command Center. Meanwhile, Water Crystal is getting a Robo Factory in order to get some high tech like Robo Bay right here. Zealot Scouts right here, meanwhile Water Crystal is getting 4th Nexus. Observers scouting around. Zealot being called back, this is actually F2. More Alcors on the way, meanwhile. This is interesting right now. He gets 2nd Factory, which I have never seen before. A 2nd Factory in a TVP. I have never seen this before. Usually you want to get a Ghost, which he already did, with the EMP upgrade coming up soon. And 2nd Factory, I am wondering what is he up to. And very, very interesting wall right here. Might take it as well. But he's like open to Zealot run by. But I'm not sure. Meanwhile, Water Crystal is getting sending over the War Prism to harass Oof's harassment. Yes. Oof's scouting with a scan. Missing on the pylon, but doesn't matter. Only important thing is there's so many gates with the Bay and Colossus coming up soon, but he didn't see it. Now we are gonna see the harassment from Water Crystal. Does he see it? Observer Rat here. Terrant is about to snipe the Observer, meanwhile Water Crystal kills only 3 SCVs. Kill 1 Ghost. 4 SCV, 5 SCV. So Water Crystal is not trying to save this four zealots. Oofs just pulled the whole army to the main, which Water Crystal abuses it and tries to take down the third base. I'm not sure Oof already scanned it and is about to move into this army, which is really dangerous because there's five ghosts already. Meanwhile, tank is sitting up right here at this spot, and they are engaged right now. Oh, the MP has been really casted, really nice. Okay, there's not so big damage done right now. The ghosts are pretty much dangerous to face. Now, Water Crystal is calling back, maybe trying to go around, I don't know. I'm still... Oh, wait, what? This is pretty much late, Vikings right here. Never mind. Fifth Nexus is coming up here. And Water Crystal is attacking the defenseless fourth base of Terran. Steam and EMP. More EMP has been thrown, and the shield is completely empty from the Water Crystal's army. Oh, Oofs is losing so much army right now. Look at the supplies. 70 supplies are gone right now. Holy sh. Nice EMP right now. And GG has been caught. Wow. This is absolutely insane. Okay. Wow. Alright. That's pretty much it. ValidG takes the today's team league, today's week number 3-1 for ValidG. I have to repeat, I'm sorry. Okay, GG, well played. And that's pretty much wrapping up. I'm gonna cast some games for VTL regular tomorrow at let me check the time. Tomorrow at 3 PM Eastern US time or 9 PM Central European time, which is about, I'm sorry, I have to look it up, which is about 18 hours. In 18 hours I'm gonna cast the next VTL team league. Make sure you tune it in if you're interested. Anything else? That's it. See you next time, either tomorrow or next time. See ya. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.